asymmetric intros. So while everyone's trying to do a warm intro, I focus on how the real world works. So in the real world, it's not a warm intro where both people want to meet each other. It's where one party really wants to meet the other party, and the other party is slightly cautious, euphemistically speaking. So then with doing an asymmetric interview, the way that it works is one person gets and begs for the email address from the intermediary. So for example, let's say you want to meet a great investor, Jeff, who works at Amazon. So you're like, Larry, I heard your friend Brad Jefferson got money from Jeff Bezos. I want to see if Mr. Bezos would be entertaining an idea of a pitch from me. And then I'd say, well, why don't you go ahead and email jeff@amazon.com and then CC me, Larry@duck9.com or Chang9@duck9.com. CC me and then email him. That's an asymmetric intro where you have to hustle and say, hi, insert your name. Hi Jeff, I am Larry Chang's friend. He gave me your email address. I wanted to reach out and do X or get your input on Y or get your feedback on Z because I read all about your perspective on Z issue. So is it okay if we set up a 5-minute phone call? You're asking this over email and then you're CCing me. And so if that email looks great, then I will reply all and be like, hey Jeff, give this kid a shot, insert your name. So Stephanie's, you know, an up and coming star inside of the local community college that I am near. And it'd be great if you could re-look, re-examine, and reply to this email. That's how an asymmetric email works. Asymmetric email intro works, where you're the primary driver. And I know in a warm intro, you're supposed to write 2 emails for both people, but that takes a perfectly symbiotic relationship. And in the real world, intros are incredibly asymmetric, where one party can greatly benefit, and the other party might eventually greatly benefit, but initially is kind of too busy to evaluate. Asymmetric intros.